Hello, my name is Jamie DeYoung. I'm an instructor for Math 135 this term, and I've prepared this video on piecewise and absolute value functions as part of that course. By the end of this video, you should be able to draw graphs of piecewise and absolute value functions and convert an absolute value function to a piecewise function. I'm going to go through several examples, and then at the end, I'll leave you with a couple of exercises to practice and to check your understanding. So the first example is just the straightforward absolute value function. So we have f of x equals the absolute value of x. If you haven't seen that before, that means that for a negative value, we will change it to a positive value of the same magnitude. So we're taking the magnitude of the value, the size of it, and not caring about the whether it's positive or negative. So when we apply this to positive values, we don't change them. The size is simply the value itself. So for, say, 1, we get f of x equals 1. For 2, f of x equals 2, and so on. Same thing for 0. The size of it is simply 0. But for negative values, that's when we actually have to change things. So when we take the value negative 1, the size of that is 1. We get rid of the negative sign. And for 2, the size is 2, and then 3, and so on. So we can now fill in what this graph actually looks like. Just imagine my lines are perfectly straight. And now, this is an absolute value function, but we could define it in a different way. So if you're familiar with piecewise functions, they're used to define graphs generally that have separate pieces that we can't simply write as a single function. Now, we can with this one, but we have to use the absolute value to do that. Whereas we can write it with a piecewise function if we don't want to have the absolute value in there. So that means we'll break it up into pieces, in this case, two pieces, because the change that we can see occurs when x equals 0. So we'll look at the values for x at least 0. So this line looks like the function f of x equals x. It's a linear function with slope 1. It passes through the origin. So we get f of x equals x for x at least 0. Now we look at the negative values, the other part of this function. So here we have a line with slope negative 1. It also passes through the origin. So that gives us f of x equals negative x for x at most 0. Now you'll note that I've defined this function twice for x equals 0. That's because the two parts of this piecewise function give the same value when x equals 0. If they didn't, then we'd have to be very careful to make sure that we didn't use or equal to in both cases. So now let's look at a different example. So here we have f of x equals 1 divided by the absolute value. So we already know how the absolute value works. For positive values, we simply take that value. So for x equals 1, we simply get 1 divided by 1. For 2, we get a half and a third and so on. We probably at this point need to see what happens at x equals a half. So we get 1 divided by a half, and that's 2. So you can see the trend here on the right-hand side of the graph. Now, when x actually equals 0, we're dividing by 0, so we don't expect the function to exist at that point. So now we'll look at the negative values. So we take 1 over, for example, the absolute value of negative 1, 1 divided by 1, which is simply 1. Then we'll have 1 divided by the absolute value of negative 2, which is a half. And we'll get a third and a quarter and so on. Now we'll have 1 divided by the absolute value of, say, negative a half. This gives us 2. And hopefully you can see at this point that the left-hand side of this graph is going to be the same as the right-hand side reflected across the vertical axis. So we'll fill that in. Now, once again, we can define a piecewise function based on this absolute valued function. So we'll have, again, the change is occurring at x equals 0, so we'll have the values above 0 and the values below 0. So for values greater than 0, we have 1 divided by the absolute value of x. That doesn't make any difference to the function. We simply get 1 divided by x. X greater than 0. And for negative values, we'll take 1 divided by the absolute value of x. This multiplies the negative value by negative 1. So it's equivalent to taking negative 1 over x for values of x less than 0. And of course, for x equals 0, this function isn't defined because it would involve dividing by 0, which doesn't yield a real value. So we've converted an absolute value function to a piecewise function in both of these cases, but we can't necessarily always go the other way. So here I have an example of a piecewise function where we actually can't convert to an absolute value function. So let's start by drawing this function. So we have f of x equals 3 provided x is greater than or equal to 2. So when x is 2, we get 3. And then everything higher than that also has a value of 3. Now we get the function x, so a line with slope 1 passing through the origin, but only for values between negative 2 and 2. So negative 2 is included in this, so at negative 2 we expect to get f of x equals negative 2. All the way up to 2, except it's only for values less than that, so points arbitrarily close to 2, but not at that actual value, which we represent generally using an open circle. So we fill in those values. And then for values less than negative 2, we get the function having a value of 0. So again, we'll use an open circle to indicate that at negative 2, it doesn't actually have that value, but everything to the left of it. So this is a piecewise representation, a drawing of this piecewise function. But in this case, we don't have a way to represent this using absolute values. So we can always get a piecewise representation of an absolute value function, but we can't necessarily go the other way. Okay, so hopefully now you've got a little bit more experience with drawing piecewise functions and absolute value functions, and you'll see how you can convert from an absolute value function to a piecewise function that is equivalent. So I'll leave you here with a couple of exercises. So for each of these two functions, you'll want to draw a graph of the function and then convert it into a piecewise function where you aren't using the absolute value. If you want to discuss these problems, you can talk on Piazza or you can come and see me in my office hours to discuss further. Thank you.